Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to cover Amazon Cognito access token customization. My name is Vasant Selvaraj. I'm a senior security specialist at AWS. First, I'm going to give an overview of Amazon Cognito. Next, I will explain what is access token customization, benefits and steps to customize access token. Finally, I'll give a practical demonstration of how to activate and customize access token. Amazon Cognito is a fully managed AWS service, which lets you to add user sign up, sign in, and access control to your web and mobile apps easily. Amazon Cognito supports sign in with social identity providers such as Facebook, Google, and Amazon, and also other enterprise identity providers via SAML 2.0. Cognito user pool manages the overhead of handling the tokens that are written from social sign-in, from OIDC and SAML IDPs. What is access token customization? After every successful authentication, Amazon Cognito returns user pool tokens to your app. You can use the tokens to grant your user access to your own server-side resources or to the Amazon API gateway. Tokens returned by Amazon Cognito are ID token, an access token, and a refresh token for the authenticated user. Both access and ID tokens contains claims about the identity of the authenticated user. The purpose of the access token is to authorize API operations. Access token contains authorization attributes in the form of user group memberships and OAuth scopes. You can refine the original scope claims to further restrict access to your resources and enforce the least privileged access, and also enrich access tokens with additional claims. Let's look at the benefits of access token customization. When you enrich access tokens with claims from other sources, such as user subscription information stored in an Amazon DynamoDB table, as shown in this architecture diagram, your application can use this enriched claim to determine the level of access and content available to the user. This reduces the need to build a custom solution to look up attributes in your application's code, thereby reducing application complexity, improving performance, and smoothing the integration experience with downstream applications. And also, you can perform fine-grained authorization by sending the access token to Amazon Verified Permission with additional claims. Amazon Verified Permissions is a scalable, fine-grained permissions management and authorization service for custom applications built by you. Amazon Verified Permissions evaluate the request against all the policies defined in the policy store and returns an allow or deny response. This slide explains the difference of access token before and after customization. As you can see, there are three additional claims are added by pre-token trigger lambda function. Let's look at the steps to customize access token. At eye level, there are three main steps. First, you have to activate advanced security features. Activating this feature will result in additional charges. Next is to enable customization of access tokens using pre-token generation trigger. Your Amazon Cognito user pool delivers two different versions of the pre-token generation trigger event to a Lambda function. Trigger event version 1 includes user attributes, group configuration, and client metadata in the event request, which you can use to customize ID token claims. Trigger event version 2 adds scopes in the event request, which you can use to customize scopes in the access token in addition to customizing other claims. Pre-token generation trigger is a Lambda function that Amazon Cognito sends a default set of claims to. These claims include OAuth 2 scopes, user pool group membership, user attributes, and others. The function can take the opportunity to make changes at runtime and return updated token claims to Amazon Cognito. Some consideration and best practices for customizing access tokens. You cannot customize certain claims and scopes such as auth underscore time, issuer and subject, or scopes such as aws.cognito.signin.user.admin. Typically, you use scope to provide access, so when you customize access tokens, you should start with your existing authorization schema and then decide whether to customize the scopes or claims or both. However, if you have a complex or fine-grained authorization requirements, then you should consider using both scopes and custom claims to pass additional contextual data to the application or to a policy-based access control service such as Amazon Verified Permissions. You should have a consistent company engineering policy to provide nomenclature guidance for scopes and claims. A syntax standard promotes globally unique variables and avoids a name collision across different application teams. For example, application X at any company can choose to name the scope as ac.appx.claim, where AC represents any company as a global identifier, and the Apex claim name represents Application X custom claim. You should keep scope and claim names as short as possible while still being descriptive. Now that we have covered a brief overview of Amazon Cognito and the customized access token, let's open to Cognito console and see this in action. In the demo, I'm going to show how to activate the advanced security features to customize access token, and then using pre-token lambda function to create new custom claims and modifying a group. Finally, trying overriding protected client to see how it works. Demo application cognito.html to demonstrate access token customization and integrated with Cognito user pool for authentication. Login as user Joy. After successful authentication, decoded access token display on browser screen for inspection. Claims and scopes are on the screen or before customization. With access token customization feature, you will add 3 new claims, suppress 1 scope, and tries to modify 1 excluded claim. Open AWS console and navigate to Cognito service. Select the user pool used for demo application. Joy is the user part of this user pool. Open App Integration tab to enable advanced security feature. Activating this feature will result in additional charges. In Advanced Security page, 2 options to choose from: enforcement method, audit only method, or full function method. Audit only method, Cognito gathers metrics on detected risk but doesn't take automatic action. Whereas full function method, it takes preventive actions to different levels of configured risk. For this demo purpose, select audit only method and save changes. Navigate to user pool properties tab, where you will be adding lambda trigger. Before adding lambda trigger, let's explore the lambda function code. Navigate to access token customization lambda created for this demo. In this code, there are 3 new claims will be added, 1 scope will be suppressed, and 2 new Cognito groups also will be added. Let's try to override 1 existing excluded issuer claim in the code. The function can take the opportunity to make changes at runtime and return updated token claims to Amazon Cognito. Let's test the lambda function using sample event. Here is an example version 2 trigger event. The sample event request contains the user attributes from the Amazon Cognito user pool and the scope claim. Navigate back to code tab to test the lambda function. The lambda trigger sends the following response back to Amazon Cognito to indicate the customization that was needed for the access tokens. You may notice lambda response code contains excluded claims, but it will be ignored by Amazon Cognito at runtime. Navigate back to user pool properties to add lambda trigger. There are 4 types of lambda trigger to choose from. Choose authentication option and pre-token generation trigger. 2 trigger event version to choose from. Version 1 to customize ID claims. To customize ID and access claims, select version 2 option. Attach the access token customized lambda created for this demo and then add this trigger to this Cognito user pool. Let's sign in again on demo app with same user Joy. After successful authentication, decoded access token display on browser screen for inspection. Claims and scopes are on the screen or after customization. Three new claims are added to access token and two new Cognito groups as well. And also you have noticed one scope is missing and it's been suppressed. Issuer claim is not modified by Lambda function. In this video, I have demonstrated how to enable and customize access token. There are some resources to get you started. On the left, AWS security blog post to know more about customized access tokens. And on the right, pre-token generation Lambda trigger documentation and some sample code. Thank you for watching this video.